Hello friends, welcome to the Cable Networking and E-Learning program for Standard 12 students of Lokmanya Tilak Mahavidyalaya Vani in association with Shikshan Prasarak Mandal Vidyalaya and Junior College. I am Anand Hood. I welcome you to the period of English. Friends, in our previous period, from our previous period, we were dealing the second section and the fifth topic of the second section, Father Returning Home by Dilip Chitre. Before we begin, let's have a glimpse, again a glimpse of the poet as well as the poem. In our previous period, we have talked about the activities, the icebreaker regarding this poem. Now, let's have a glimpse of the poet Dilip Chitre and the poem Father Returning Home. Dilip Chitre was a celebrated bilingual poet and translator with a remarkable world of Marathi and English. His versatile creativity extends to painting, filmmaking, and his notable contribution as a magazine columnist. He received the prestigious Sahitya Akademi Award both for poetry as well as for his well-known translation work Sesh Tuka, popular Abhangas, spiritual poem that is by Sant Tukaram. He had started translation of literary work of Sants in Marathi at the age of 16. Exile, alienation, self-disintegration and death are observed to be the major theme of his work. The poem, Father Returning Home, is taken from Traveling in a Cage. It draws a portrait of a suburban commuter. It depicts his dull, monotonous, exhausting and equally pitiable daily routine. It describes a forced alienation at home, which is reflected through the stale food and lack of sharing. His children refuse to share their joy and sorrow with the hard-working father, who as a result is forced to retire into solitude. This very painful loneliness is a symbol of man's isolation from the materialistic man-made world. That means we have to witness a suburban common people who is a commuter. And this poem is an autobiography of Dilip Chitre. Dilip Chitre has experienced this at his home. Let's see what Dilip Chitre has sketched in Father Returning Home. Let's see the poem. My father travels on the late evening train. Dilip Chitre is sketching, is depicting the life of his father. He said us that my father travels on the late evening train. Friends, let's see the figure of speech which Dilip Chitre has mentioned in these lines. Dilip Chitre has used so many figure of speech regarding each and every line of his, nearly every line of this poem. Then what figure of speech is used here? My father travels on the late evening train. You will find that the sound T is being repeated here, and so the figure of speech is alliteration. Sound of T is repeated. Then the next line, standing among silent commuter. What is commuter? Commuter means, it appears on your screen, those who travel regularly from one place to another, typically to work. Those who are traveler, that travels to their office daily, are supposed to be called as commuter. Standing alone, standing among silent commuter in the yellow field, in the yellow light. That means his father is standing in a compartment of a train. Which figure of speech is used here? Let's see. Again, you will find that the sound S is repeated here. So, it is alliteration. The third line, suburb slide past. Suburbs slide past his unseen eyes. Look at this line. His unseen eyes. So many figure of speech are used here. Suburb side past. Here also, let's see which figure of speech are used here. First of all, the alliteration sound of S is repeated. Then paradox. Why it is paradox? Because phrase unseen eyes itself is contradictory. It is contradictory. Unseen eyes. The quality of eyes is to see. And unseen is attached with eyes. And so this is contradictory. So the paradox figure of speech is used here. Then personification is also. Suburb are given the animate quality of sliding past. Suburb is passing. Suburb slide past. So personification is also there. Then transfer epithet. The epithet unseen has been transferred to the poet to his eyes. So these four figure of speeches are used in a single line. Now we will see first the meaning of these three lines. Dilip Chitre, the poem, begins with the speaker's description of his father traveling home in a late evening train. The father is traveling in a late evening train. After a long day of work, he is returning to his home. Here, the poet Dilip Chitre touchingly described the evening routine of an ordinary old man who is commuter on a local train. Dilip Chitre is sketching the sketch of a common man, his daily evening routine to his home. He is standing amongst the passenger. His father is standing amongst the passenger in the yellow lighted compartment. He is standing in a yellow lighted compartment. The cheerless surrounding intensify his sense of gloom. He has no intention to look at the suburban slide past. The suburban slides are passing away. But he don't want to watch them. He don't want to see them. As he doesn't find anything interesting. Because he didn't find anything interesting in the passing slides of the suburb. Hence, adding to his monotony. Now, let's see in Marathi. My father traveling on the late evening train. दिलीप चित्रेंनी आपल्या वडिलांचं चित्र या ठिकाणी आपल्या समोर रेखाटलेलं आहे की ते कशा पद्धतीने जे नित्य नियमांनी आपल्या ट्रेन ऑफिसला जायचे, ऑफिसमधनं संध्याकाळ झाली की आपल्या ट्रेननी घरी परत यायची. या ठिकाणी वडिलांच्या माध्यमातून कॉमन मॅनचं चित्र या ठिकाणी दिलीप चित्रे आपल्या समोर उभं करण्याचा प्रयत्न करतायत की कॉमन मॅनचं रुटीन कसं असते, कशा पद्धतीने लेट ट्रेन मध्ये घरी येण्याकरता त्यांना निघावं लागतं. स्टँडिंग अमंग सायलेंट कम्युटर, येताना लोकलमध्ये इतकी गर्दी असते आपल्यालाही माहिती आहे की त्याच्यात चुपचापपणे ते उभे आहेत इन अ येलो लाइटेड कंपार्टमेंट. जो कोणत्या डब्यामध्ये ते चढलेले आहे त्या ठिकाणी जो ग्लुमी लाईट, ज्याला आपण येलो लाईट म्हणतोय या ठिकाणी, अशा प्रकारातल्या लाईटच्या प्रकाशामध्ये ते एकटेच त्या ठिकाणी उभे आहेत. ते एकटेच उभे आहे म्हणजे ते एकटे त्या ठिकाणी उभे आहेत, आजूबाजूला भरपूर गर्दी आहे म्हणूनच उभे आहे. सबर्ब साइड पास्ट हिज अनसीन आईज, त्यांच्या डोळ्यासमोरन खिडकीमधनं कित्येक उपनगरांच्या सबर्ब म्हणजे उपनगर उपनगरांच्या कित्येक स्लाइड्स पास होत आहेत, पण त्यांना त्या गोष्टींकडे बघण्याचं अजिबात स्वारस्य दिसत नाही आहे. हीच गोष्ट या ठिकाणी त्या वडिलांची मानसिकता आपल्याला दर्शवणारी दिसत आहे की कशा पद्धतीने एक ग्लुमिनेस त्यांच्यामध्ये आपल्याला आलेला दिसतोय. सेन्स ऑफ ग्लुमिनेस ज्याला आपण कुठेतरी ते घरांमध्ये म्हणा किंवा इतरत्र म्हणा सगळ्या ठिकाणी एकटे पडलेले दिसत आहे ही भावना, कारण त्यांना आपल्या आजूबाजूला काय घडते आहे, कोण कुठे जात आहे, त्यांचे डोळे बघून सुद्धा न बघितल्यासारखं आव ते या ठिकाणी आणताना आपल्याला दिसत आहे. नाऊ लेट सी व्हॉट इज देअर इन द नेक्स्ट फोर लाईन्स. हिज शर्ट अँड पॅन्ट आर सॉगी. सॉगी, what is soggy? Soggy means wet, watery. And his black raincoat stained with mud. He is wearing a raincoat and yet his pant and shirts are soggy. Yes, because of that the raincoat, because of the sweating and water entering from that raincoat, the clothes became soggy. And his raincoat was also stained. What is stained? Stained means make dirty or spotty. His raincoat was also dirty because of the mud. And his bag, he is carrying a bag stuffed with books, is falling apart. He is carrying a bag with him and in that bag there are books which are stuffed, and as if he is falling apart, he is not able to carry the load of that bag. His eyes dim by age. Because of the age, his eyes getting dimmed and dim. Fade. Sorry, let's see the figure of speech used in the line. Stained with mud and his bag stuck with books. Here, alliteration is used because the sound of S is repeated in this line. His eyes dim by age. Fed. What is fed? Fed means lose freshness, vigor. He has lost his freshness. There are two possibilities why he has lost his freshness. Because of the office work, he has lost his freshness. And the next thing, where he is going towards his home. And he knows that while entering into the home, there is no one who is going to care for him. And so he has lost his freshness and vigor. Fed homework, homewards, he is going towards his home through the humid monsoon night. It was a humid monsoon night. Which figure of speech is used here? Let's see. It is transfer epithet. The epithet humid has been transferred from the weather to the night. Let's see the meaning of these four lines again. It is a rainy day. It is a rainy day as his clothes are wet and his raincoat muddy. He is struggling to carry his bag, which is stuffed with books. And this shows that the reference of the book indicates that he is an learned, educated man. His poor eyesight further fades at the prospects of returning home. Maybe his eyesight lost freshness, faded because of the prospect of returning home. Or maybe he was so much tired in his office work, so he has lost his freshness, vigor. But his poor eyesight further faded at the prospects of returning home, as home is also a place where he feels isolated. Maybe at home he also feels isolated, though there is his wife, still he feels isolated. Let's see in Marathi. His shirt and pants are soggy. जसं आपल्याला सांगितलं गेलेलं आहे वरती की सबर्बियन स्लाइड्स त्याच्या समोरून जात आहेत, पण ते बघण्यामध्ये त्यांना इंटरेस्ट नाही आहे. त्यांचा शर्ट आणि पॅन्ट सॉगी झालेले आहेत, वेट झालेले आहेत. रेनकोट घातलेला आहे पण तरीही कपडे ओले झालेले आहेत, आणि रेनकोट सुद्धा स्टेन चिखलांनी माखलेला आपल्याला दिसतो आहे. त्यांच्यासोबत ते एक जी बॅग कॅरी करत आहे, इट इज स्टक विथ बुक्स. त्याच्यात पुस्तकं कोंबलेले दिसत आहेत, भरलेले दिसत आहेत, आणि त्या बॅगचं वजन इतकं जड झालेलं असावं की ही इज फॉलिंग अपार्ट. त्यांना ते सहन होत नाही आहे, इज ट्रम्बलिंग. हिज आईज डीम्ड, डोळे सुद्धा डीम झालेले आहेत. हिज आईज डीम बाय एज, वयोमानाने डोळे कमजोर होत चाललेले आहेत. फेड होमवर्ड थ्रू द ह्युमिड मान्सून नाईट. मे बी दोन गोष्टी या ठिकाणी शक्यता दिसत आहेत की फेड हा जो शब्द प्रयोग, फ्रेशनेस, लॉस्ट फ्रेशनेस जो आपण म्हटलेला आहे, तो दोन गोष्टींमुळे आहे. एक तर ते कामाने इतके थकलेले आहेत की घरी जात असताना सुद्धा त्यांच्या अंगात त्राण नाही आहे. पण दुसरी शक्यता इथे जास्त ही या पद्धतीची आहे, कारण जसं जसं आपण कवितेमध्ये अग्रेसर होणार आहोत आपल्याला ही गोष्ट कळणार आहे की घरी कोणीही त्यांची वाट पाहत नाही आहे, आणि घरी सुद्धा ते आयसोलेटेड एकाकीच अनुभव घेतात, एकाकीपणाचाच अनुभव त्यांना येतो. म्हणून घरी जात असताना सुद्धा त्यांना त्यांच्या अंगात फ्रेशनेस किंवा विगर प्रकारात कुठेही दिसत नाही आहे, कारण त्यांना माहिती आहे घरी गेल्यावर सुद्धा तेच सगळं काही आहे. आणि म्हणून या ठिकाणी या वडिलांची ही अवस्था अशा पद्धतीची आपल्याला रेखाटताना दिलीप चित्रे दिसत आहेत. यानंतर काय येत आहे बघा. नाव आय कॅन सी हिम गेटिंग ऑफ द ट्रेन. नाव ही इज गेटिंग ऑफ द ट्रेन, लाईक अ वर्ड ड्रॉप फ्रॉम अ लॉंग सेंटेन्स. लुक ॲट द लाईन. First of all, we will think of the figure of speech. Which figure of speech is used here? Simile. Because there is like. The action of the father getting off from the train is directly compared to a word being dropped from a long sentence with the use of the word like. We are seeing like here. It is direct comparison. So it is simile. He hurried across the length of the grey platform. What is grey platform? The meaning appeared on your screen. It is grey due to cement. The buildings are made of cement, so it is grey. But here, grey suggests old age. Grey suggests old age, dullness, sordidness of a father's life. Dullness of a father's life, it represents. And the figure of speech, which figure of speech is used here? Here, alliteration, the sound of H. The sound of H. It is also metaphor. The grey platform is indirectly compared to the father's age. The grey platform is compared with the age of the father. He hurried across the length of the grey platform and crosses the railway line, enters the lane. His chappals, the footwear we use, the chappals are sticky with mud, but he hurries onwards. What Dilip Chitre has sketched here? He get down, the father get down from the train like a word dropped from a long sentence. This is comparison. As if a long sentence, from a long sentence, a word is dropped out, he got out of the train. As though he is uniform, as he is unimportant or insignificant to the rest of the world. As if nobody cares for this man. He hurries across the grey platform. He tried to cross that platform in a hurry, which is symbolic of his dullness. Symbolic of his dull and monotonous life. This is the symbol of his dull and monotonous life, and enters the lane by crossing the railway line. Though his footwear is muddy, he continues to walk. Now we will see what is given in Marathi. As I can see him getting off the train, he is getting off the train like a word dropped from a long sentence. जसा एखाद्या वाक्यामधला एखादा शब्द आपण नकळत गळावा, तशा पद्धतीने ते वडील ट्रेन मधून खालती उतरले. घाई घाईत हरीज अक्रॉस द लेंथ ऑफ द ग्रे प्लॅटफॉर्म. तो जो प्लॅटफॉर्म आहे तो क्रॉस करण्याचा प्रयत्न करतात. इथे ग्रे हा शब्द ओल्ड एज दर्शवतो आहे, डलनेस दर्शवतो आहे. वडिलांचं जे डलनेस असेल आहे ते दर्शवतो आहे. क्रॉसिंग क्रॉसेस द रेल्वे लाईन, एंटर्स द लेन. लगेच तो प्लॅटफॉर्म क्रॉस करून, लाईन क्रॉस करून ते एका समोरच्या लेनमध्ये, गल्लीमध्ये शिरतात जिकडून त्यांचं घर असावं. हिज चप्पल आर स्टिकी विथ मड. चपलेला दुनियाभरचा चिखल लागलेला, त्याच्यामुळे ते स्टिकी झालेले आहेत. बट ही हरीज ऑनवर्ड्स, पण त्यांना त्याची पर्वा नाही आहे. आणि ते आपलं एकच काम, आपल्या घराकडे जाण्याचं काम ते या ठिकाणी करताना आपल्याला दिसत आहेत. नाऊ लेट सी व्हॉट द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन. As time, we are approaching our time, we will see the next portion in our next period. For today, I am giving you a homework. Let's see what the homework is. Fade homewards through the humid monsoon night. We have read this line. In the above line, the weather is humid, not the night. Weather is humid, not the night. Night is not humid. Weather is humid. The epithet or objective is transferred from the weather to night. But जसं आपण नेहमी म्हणतो की रात्री किती ह्युमिडिटी आहे, किती ह्युमिड आहे, तर रात्र ह्युमिड नाही आहे. तर रात्रीचं जे वातावरण असते ते वातावरण ह्युमिड असते असं आपण. आणि म्हणूनच द स्पीकर ऑफ स्पीच इज ट्रान्सफर्ड इपिथेट. आपण आतापर्यंत उदाहरण बघितले त्याचे, असेच उदाहरण आपल्याला कवितेत अजून शोधायचे आहे. फाइंड आउट सच अदर एक्झाम्पल्स, अदर एक्सप्रेशन्स फ्रॉम द पोएम. अजून वेगवेगळ्या ओळी या कवितेतनं आपल्याला शोधायच्या आहेत, हे एक होमवर्क. आणि दुसरं होमवर्क आपल्याला या ठिकाणी देतो आहे, आयडेंटिफाय अँड राईट द लाईन्स फ्रॉम द पोएम विच एक्सप्रेस द फॉलोइंग फिगर ऑफ स्पीच. कोणते फिगर ऑफ स्पीच आहे, आपण तीन इथे दिलेले आहेत. ऑनोमॅटोपोईचा आपल्याला अजून बघायचं आहे, पण सिमिली आणि ॲलिटरेशनचे आपण भरपूर एक्झाम्पल्स बघितलेले आहेत. त्या लाईन्स कोणत्या आहेत त्या आपल्याला या ठिकाणी लिहायच्या आहेत. काइंडली नोट दिस होमवर्क डाऊन, अँड इफ यू हॅव सम प्रॉब्लेम्स रिगार्डिंग टुडेज एक्सप्लेनेशन, माय नंबर इज फ्लॅशिंग ऑन युअर स्क्रीन, काइंडली नोट इट डाऊन अँड कॉन्टॅक्ट मी. माझा नंबर आपल्या स्क्रीनवर फ्लॅश होतो आहे. आपल्याला काहीही आजच्या व्हिडिओच्या संदर्भात प्रॉब्लेम असतील तर कृपया फोन करून विचारावं, आणि होमवर्क माझ्या पर्सनल व्हॉट्सअप नंबरवर व्हॉट्सअप करावं किंवा ग्रुपमध्ये करावं. हाच व्हिडिओ जर आपल्याला पुन्हा पाहायचा असेल तर कॉलेजची यूट्यूब साईट आपल्या समोर ठेवलेली आहे, प्रिन्सिपल LTM, आणि यूट्यूब लिंक खालती दिलेली आहे. माझे व्हिडिओज आपल्याला बघायचे असतील तर त्याची बॅकअप लिंक सुद्धा आपल्या समोर दिलेली आहे. काइंडली दोन्ही चॅनल्स सबस्क्राइब करा, जेणेकरून आपला प्रतिसाद आम्हाला प्राप्त होईल. थँक्यू.